Today, we're going past surface-level conversation about how tools enable LLMs to take action beyond just generating text. Instead, we'll dive under the hood to see exactly how the BeeAI framework, which is an open-source AI agent framework built for developers, actually implements and executes tools in production. We're going to cover the whole tool lifecycle, from creating the tool, to executing it and observing its actions, to how the tool output is consumed by the LLM, and then at the end, we're going to see it in action. In the BeeAI framework, a tool is an executable component that extends an LLM's capabilities. This could be a procedural code function, an API call to an external service, a database query or file system operation, or an MCP or model context protocol server, or any custom business logic. Each tool has a name, description, and usually an input schema that an LLM uses to pick the right tool call. The BeeAI framework provides some built-in tools, so you don't need to recreate the wheel for common tools like internet search, running Python code in a safe sandboxed environment, and encouraging the agent to think using a React pattern. But you can also create your own custom tools if needed. There are two primary ways to create custom tools in BeeAI. For simpler functions, you can add a tool decorator like this. The framework automatically extracts the function signature to create a pedantic input schema, uses the doc string as a description, and wraps everything in a proper tool class. But for more complex tool calls, you can extend the tool class by providing a data model for the tool, setting the run options, and providing the expected tool output. Once tools are created, they're passed to the agent as a list. Then the agent passes the allowed tools to the LLM to make a selection on what tool should be called. So next, the framework executes the tool call, handling input validation, execution, error handling, results collection, and much more. And lastly, the agent adds the tool results to memory and loops back to the LLM for the next decision, unless a final answer is triggered. Next, we have the MCP tool. MCP tools are external services that expose endpoints following the Model Context Protocol, a standard from Anthropic that allows language models to call tools. They are handled mostly the same way and follow the same tool calling pattern. The framework's built-in retry and error handling becomes even more valuable with MCP tools, since they involve network calls that can fail. So the same retry logic that handles the local tool errors also handles MCP connection issues, timeouts, and server errors. So from the agent's perspective, MCP tools are just tools in a list. All in all, the BeeAI framework includes many features that make it production ready. But some of the most important ones when it comes to tool calling are the built-in observability, so you can understand and even log your agent's actions. Cycle detection that prevents infinite tool call loops, built-in retry logic and memory persistence, and lastly, type validation, so the entire agent run doesn't accidentally break from an invalid input. Now, let's walk through a quick demo to see it all in action. In this scenario, we have a company analysis agent that has access to three tools to help complete its task. It has a built-in think tool, which is a reasoning module forcing the agent to follow a react or reasoning and acting pattern with chain of thought reasoning. It also has an MCP internet search tool, and we've given it a custom tool that performs retrieval to gather context from an internal database that we've preceded with some synthetic documents. This process is also known as RAG or retrieval augmented generation. So now I'm going to run the script. And I'm going to give you the question, when is the next pilot and what is it on? And it should know what I'm talking about, even though it doesn't have context from the system prompt. So as the agent runs, we can see that the agent first checks its conditional tools, and because of the requirement, it forces the think tool call first. So we can see it thinking there. Then it goes back to the LLM to make another tool choice based on its allowed tools for this specific iteration. So the LLM decides to call the internal search tool. So this is a custom RAG tool that searches a database for relevant internal documents. It also realizes that it needs to do a more broad internet search, so it calls the MCP internet search tool, which is running on a local MCP server with access to the Tavly search tool on my device. And we can see that's running on standard I/O because it's running locally on my device. And then once the LLM feels like it's had enough information, it provides the final answer. And the framework is responsible for returning that to the user. So what have we learned from going under the hood of the BeeAI framework? That the LLM is just a small piece of the puzzle. The framework actually handles a lot of the orchestration and execution logic, so you can focus on the business logic. So if you're ready to give the BeeAI framework a try for your AI agents, you can find the GitHub and documentation links in the show notes below. Happy building.